I want to address the situation in Afghanistan, where there was an attack on our embassy in Kabul today. It appears that a number of Afghan civilians have been hurt, and we, of course, will do all we can to assist them. There are no reports of casualties among embassy personnel at this time. We are following this very closely, also the unfolding situation in the area, including at NATO ISAF headquarters, which, for those of you who have been in Kabul, you know is across the street from our embassy compound. We will take all necessary steps, not only to ensure the safety of our people, but to secure the area and to ensure that those who perpetrated this attack are dealt with. So the United States government will continue our efforts to support religious freedom. We are engaging with faith groups to address the issues that affect them. Our embassies encourage interfaith dialogue, and we will speak out against efforts to curtail religious freedom. Because it is our core conviction that religious tolerance is one of the essential elements, not only of a sustainable democracy, but of a peaceful society that respects the rights and dignity of each individual. People who have a voice in how they are governed, no matter what their identity or ethnicity or religion, are more likely to have a stake in both their governments and their society's success. That is good for stability, for American national security, and for global security.
As you know, the State Department is mandated by law to produce this report each year. The Secretary of State also designates countries of particular concern, countries whose governments have, and I quote the statute, engaged in or tolerated particularly severe violations of religious freedom. Secretary Clinton has designated 8 states as countries of particular concern. They are Burma, China, Eritrea, Iran, North Korea, Saudi Arabia, Sudan, and Uzbekistan. All of these countries have been long-term, chronic, and egregious violators of religious freedom. The report documents in full detail the violations that have prompted these designations. In Burma, for example, hundreds of Buddhist monks are still in prison, and the government refuses to recognize that the Rohingya, a Muslim ethnic minority, are Burmese citizens. In China, the government's overall level of respect for religious freedom declined in 2010, and has worsened this year. The repression of Tibetan Buddhists and Uyghur Muslims continues. In Iran, members of the Baha'i are arrested, expelled from university, and their leaders languish in prison. Saudi Arabia prohibits the public practice of any religion other than Islam, and the government discriminates against the Shia minority. And in Uzbekistan, it's illegal to proselytize, and it's dangerous for a Muslim even to discuss religious issues outside of a state-sanctioned mosque. These and many other violations in the 8 countries of particular concern are spelled out in great detail in the reports.